Hello viewers, welcome to Damu Education. If you're not yet subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell icon. So below red color subscribe button will be there. Please subscribe there. So our next question, they are telling that here they are given one figure combination of two triangles. Here AC is making right angle at C, that is 90 degree. It's telling that in question they are telling that C at there 90 degree and AC is perpendicular to BC. So AC is perpendicular to BC. What is the conditions that are given right at all? So perpendicular to BC. So AC is perpendicular to BC. Our next one, M is the midpoint of AB. So M is, this is the midpoint of, this is the midpoint of AB. So for AB, that is M is the midpoint, it is dividing AB into two equal arcs. Then here M is joined with the C. M is joined with the C and CM is produced to D and D to B is joined. That is the question they are given. So DM will be equal to, what is next one? So they are given DM. So this is DM will be equal to CM. So DM will be equal to CM. They only given that in the question. So first question, what they are given is, try to check AMC is congruent to BMD. So first one, what they are given. So for the first one, they have to put telling that triangle AMC will be equal to triangle BMD. So we have to show these two triangles. So let's consider this is one triangle and this is another triangle. So this is the point where that two are joining, that is the midpoint. So let's take here AMC congruent to BMD. So let's consider the curve, this one. So let's take, this is this side, what they are telling that CM will be equal to DM. So if you consider these triangles, these two triangles, then these angles DM will be equal to DM will be equal to CM. So that is the first one, you can say that one. Then next one, what you can say here is M is the midpoint. This is given. This is given that. And M is the midpoint, it will going to divide AB into two equal halves. That means AM will be equal to BM. So AM will be equal to BM. That is M is midpoint. M is midpoint. So midpoint. So M is midpoint. So based on that, AM will be equal to BM. You can say that one. Then if you consider these two angles. So at M, if you take that angles will be, so this is the angle. So this is the angles. The two are, this is the angles. Let's take, this is vertically opposite angles. So that is CMA will be equal to BMD. So BMD. So how you can say these angles, let's take this is X degrees and this is Y degrees. So here CMA is X degree will be equal to Y degrees. By using what you can say how it is vertically opposite angles. So this is from vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. So by using what you can say here is SAS. By using of which congruency criterion? By SAS congruency rule. By SAS congruency rule, what you can say here is both the triangles, triangle AMC will be equal to, is congruent to triangle BMD. So BMD. So by using of both the all the conditions, we are shown that first one AMC will be equal to BMD. That is the case. Our second one is angle DBC is right angle. So we have to show this one as right angle. So we have to make it this one as right angle. Since second one, how you can say here is AC is perpendicular to BC. So AC is perpendicular to BC and if you take AC is parallel to DB and AC is parallel to DB. So this line is parallel to this one. So then what is this? DC is acting as transversal. So DC acting as transversal. DC is transversal. DC is transversal, and what you can see here is, so this angle, or you can take it this angle. So let's take this angle will be equal to this angle. That is, angle C will be equal to angle D. How you can say angle C will be angle alternate interior angles? So let's consider this angle and this angle. So let's take this C will be equal to angle D. Angle C will be equal to angle D, that is alternate interior angles. By using alternate interior angles, what you can say, this is acting as transversal, these two angles are equal, and this angle and this AC and DB are parallel to each other, then what you can say, this is the complete angle will be equal to this angle. That is, ACB, that is angle C is right angle, already we know that angle C, at angle C, that two are angles also equal, that two are right angles. By using of that, you can say this is DB is also perpendicular to BC. By using AC is parallel to DB. AC is parallel to DB, then AC is perpendicular to BC, then that also, if it is a parallel, means the distance between two lines will be always equal. So AC is parallel to DB, that is DB is perpendicular to BC, then what you can say here is, therefore, what you can say, so here angle DBC is right angle. So angle DBC is right angle. You can say that one right angle, since what you can say, therefore angle DBC is equal to 90 degrees. Angle DBC is 90 degrees, already been shown that. So by using all these conditions, you can say that one. Our third one is angle DBC is congruent to angle ACB. So DBC, now they are asking that right angles, angle DBC will be equal to angle ACB. So these two triangles they are asking here. So let's consider for third one, you can say third one, angle DBC means what they are asking here, BC is a common and angles also right angles. So let's consider in DBC triangle, what you can say here is AC will be equal to DB. AC will be equal to DB, and that is given, and they are equal and parallel to each other also. Then what is the next one? Then right angle ACB, angle ACB will be equal to angle DBC, that is 90 degrees. This is right angles. Right angles, both are equal. So right angles and both are equal. Our next one, what you can write it here is these angles. Then what you can go? Angles, and BC is a common side for the both. So DBC, ACB, BC is common side. So you can write BC will be equal to BC, that is common side. Common side. By using of what you can say? Side angle side. Side angle side. By using of side angle side, that is the SCA's congruency rule. So by SCA's congruency rule or criterion congruency rule, what you can say? Third one, angle DBC and triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. Triangle ACB. So these are the, like this we need to take the conditions. So these are the conditions we have to take the proof and so. Then CM will be equal to half AB. So CM will be equal to half AB. So here CM is equal to half AB. Since by using of which criterion rule? So by using of what you can say, fourth one, from congruency rule, triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. From CPCT, corresponding parts of congruency triangles. So from CPCT, So before that also, by using of CBSE rules only we are taking this is, so this is also CBSE rules we are taking, and AC will be equal to DB. We taken from AC will be equal to DB. So from first one we are taking the conditions. So by using of all CBSEs only we are doing the calculation here, don't get confused. So for everything we are taking the previous values, previous proofs. So from CBSE what you can say here is by using of this DC will be equal to AB. So DC will be equal to AB. Then what you can say here is M is the midpoint, DM will be equal to CM. So already they are given, DM will be equal to CM. Then if you take off of this both, if you take off DC, if you take, let's take off of the DC, off DC, then off AB. So of DC means it is maybe DM or CM. So you can take of of DC means you can take DM, that will be equal to of AB, or you can take CM also. CM will be equal to of AB. So that is the hence we are proved that is CM will be equal to of AB. So like this, we need to prove the all the cases by using. Don't forget that. So here we should use always CBSE corresponding parts of congruency triangles by the given questions. If you like the video, please give thumbs up and please subscribe.